What's up people, it's your boy Leaf, and if you guys are new to my channel, I just started playing Apex. I know it's kind of late, it's already season 12, but smash that subscribe button if you guys want to come and learn with me as I try to improve and give you guys some tips and lessons as I learn along the way. But today we're going to be focusing on what I think is the most important skill in Apex, which has to be confidence. I know aiming, map knowledge, and knowing rotations are very important as well, but if you don't have the confidence in pushing fights and in yourself, you will end up playing it slow or campy, which will only make all these important skills even harder to accomplish. So the best way to improve your confidence is to choose your favorite legend, play some matches, and do not expect a win, but instead press that W key and fight as many people as you guys can. In this video, you'll see me do the exact same thing and dying many times. I did decide to play Horizon because her passive makes movement a lot easier to do, which helps me focus on my split decision making within fights. We did not get a win in this video, but that's totally okay because we are focusing on building our confidence in gunfights. You don't want to miss the ending though, because I will be giving a quick VOD review and giving some tips about how I could have won that fight if I played it better. If you guys like the video or learned something, smash that like button. It helps me out a whole bunch and it's totally free. If you guys got any more tips, let me know in the comments. Enjoy the video. Peace. We should head here. Three pills, no gun. Three pills. Get one man's out. First blood. Round one. Begin. Firing broken enemy shield. Good, we're inside. Taking damage.
Plenty of fight left in me. All those numpties are down for the count.
Oh my God, dude. From behind.
And that was the last one.
That was not bad. Got a nice little wall jump there. Got a no rag? I would like an R3, please. What?
My bad.
Got our pal's banner.
I thought I was able to go there, that's why I guess I couldn't.
Attention. Gonna bash yourself. Here's a pick me up.
Shields. I need a shot.
Heavy ammo here. Watch in here. Shields recharging.
Straight down. Oh my god. Fuck, bro.
Recharging my shield.
You got this, dude. You got this.
Reloading. All those numpties are down for the count.
Good flash. They're not getting back up again.
No, we're going to work on confidence. We're working on confidence and movement. But
reloading. Shields recharging.
Bogey in my crosshairs.
You have to pick me up, pals. Killed a hooligan.
Hells yeah, that was badass.
Are we numpty right here? Reloading.
Reloading.
My shield. Hooligan over here. Look, an enemy shoot. Reloading. Look, an enemy shield. Replicator entering orbit. I claim this bot. Numpty in our orbit.
No, fuck.
Better luck next time.
Oh, ran right into them. All right, so as you guys can see, we just revived our Valkyrie, and we're pushing back to her box to try to get her loot back. One thing here is she ends up marking that there's enemies here, and in hindsight, I should have not been like a total idiot and just pushing this. I mean, it's really important to push as many enemies as you can, but you also gotta be really smart about how you're approaching the situation. And in my head right here, I wasn't thinking the fact that earlier I just saw someone reviving somebody. And also, I was feeling pretty hot from getting 6 kills, and like this is like a good pace game for me. So I was just excited to just try to get as many fights as I can. I should have played it slower. I should have paid attention to see what the heck was over there, because as you guys saw in the video, we end up pushing forward and we end up fighting 2 people right here. So right here, I was like, oh shit, I'm getting shot at. And I wasn't too worried until I saw that guy on my left there. And then once that happened, I was like, oh shit, I need to get out of this situation, right? So Horizon's a great legend for this, because I could just press my Q and kind of get out of this situation real quick. And then sadly, my Valkyrie got dropped. I also forgot that she has no loot, so I shouldn't have pushed this fight so hard. If anything, I should have definitely played it a little bit slower, just because it's essentially a 1v2 and my Valk is just like a meat shield. But I end up using my ulti here, and it was a great ulti. I was also able to get my Arc Star off. So that right there was awesome. I was very happy at how I used my ultimate there. But my big mistake is right here. I shoot the Horizon and I hit flesh, right? So in my head, all I'm seeing is freaking blood. And I'm like, oh yeah, so this is easy. If I get the easy knock on the Horizon, she's low. I threw an Arc Star, it hit both of them. Like, the Bangalore is not gonna have any armor as well, right? So that's what I was thinking right here. So I shouldn't have ego child this right here, but like I said, I assumed both of them had no armor, which was a bad idea. Because ideally in a 1v2 or even a 1v3 scenario, you want to isolate your fights for a 1v1. And right here, it's, as you guys can see, there's freaking 2 people on my screen, right? So even though the Horizon was low, what I should have done was continue rotating behind this crate and, you know, maybe just get in a bat real quick, because at least then I could reset the pace. Because if I bat, I'm pretty sure the Horizon's gonna bat, but then the Bangalore is gonna have to keep the pressure on me in order for me to not, you know, take advantage of whatever's happening. So if anything, at the end, Bangalore would be low and Horizon would be like have more shield, but I reset the fight. But instead, because I saw blood in the water, I decided to ego chow this like an idiot. Also, even if I was full health, I don't think I would have won this fight, just because in Apex, the time to kill is so long. And if 2 people are shooting at 1 person, they're definitely gonna, you know, die before you even get 1 kill. So like I said, right here, I end up dying. As you can tell, I was pretty upset about it, but it's okay, because we were trying to build a confidence and just kind of learn how to play better. I would recommend doing this in solos, just because at least then you could figure out how to, I guess, rely on yourself more than having another teammate who's your friend giving comms, you know. All in all, I think we've learned some very good lessons and we build our confidence, because like I said, I was feeling confident in that fight there with my 6 kills being kill leader, but I should have still played it a little bit smarter, and, you know, dialed it back a little bit. But I hope you guys learned something from this video. If you guys do, smash that like button, and like I said before, subscribe if you guys want to see me grow and figure out how to play this freaking game and give you guys some tips of what I learned as well. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.